that the ancient people, when they were formulating the new religion that they were dreaming up, they accepted some of the customs of the people of that day into their new religion so that the people would be able to relate to it. It won't be a whole totally new kind of religion that nobody right. wants anything to do with. It has some of the old remnants of you know, the religion that you used to believe.
Well, and see, that's the thing
so
about the...
So, therefore, they make it close to what you used to believe. So it's very simple. We just call it Christianity today. But go on and believe the same thing. It all has the same thing.
Right.
And therefore, people will more readily accept this new religion called Christianity.
Well, right. And I think that part of the adaptation of the symbol of the cross had to do with attracting other pagans because various pagan beliefs previous to Christianity had utilized a symbol very similar to what people would recognize today as the Celtic cross.
That's
right?
Exactly right.
And the Celtic cross, yes, there's a lot of symbolism built into that because there's a lot of interesting artwork that is of a particular style. And we see this in places like Ireland and Scotland, prominently displayed as symbols of Christianity. But what they don't recognize is that this pre-existed Christianity. A lot of people don't recognize. I'm not saying you, Jordan, but a lot of people don't recognize that they are literally adhering to older pagan customs by utilizing this very thing. And what were pagans utilizing this symbol for? Exactly the same thing you just explained, which is that they were observers of the sky. They utilized, you know, the zodiac, if you will, in order to understand the world around them. It told them how the seasons were going. It told them what time of year it was so they could plant things or move to a different place or store their food, so on and so forth. There's a very practical reason, not just that it encompassed these elements just randomly, but I mean, there's also practical reasoning behind it. You know, just like most things, if it serves more than one purpose, it's definitely a whole lot more valuable. So to attract the pagans who had other practices locally, because there were certain pagan practices that were only localized to particular areas in Europe and in other places. There were literally gods, you know, in quotes, that resided only in a particular swamp, only in a particular forest, only in a particular, and they were thought to be gods by, you know, and pagan, by the way, just so we get very clear on this. When you use the word pagan, in a lot of cases, what you're talking about is the common folk, the common
That's
people.
Right.
It is not about evil. It is not about, the demonic.
No. Pagan, it goes back to a word.
Right.
And it goes back to the Roman Empire when Caesar accepted Christianity as a state religion. It became very fashionable that if you wanted to be in with Caesar and you wanted to be in with the in crowd in Rome, then you would accept this new religion that Caesar would now profess to believe called Christianity with the cross in the sky. And the sun on the cross. And so if you really want to be somebody in government and in Rome, you now accept a new religion because everybody is doing it. Caesar is now proclaiming himself a Christian. So if you got any brains at all and you want to stay in business, you want to be in with the in crowd, then you accept the new religion called Christianity. But in doing so, all of the millions of people in the empire that were out in the Heatherlands, out in the other countries around the Mediterranean that were not in Rome, hanging out with Caesar and all the in crowd, they were just called the regular people. The regular people, ordinary people, farmers and people, shoemakers and whatever they were, that were living in the empire, but they weren't part of the in crowd like you were.
Right.
And so therefore the people on the in crowd, they were the new Christians. Why? Because Caesar is a Christian. And now I'm going to be a Christian because of it. But the people, the regular people, were referred to in Latin as pagans. Pagans simply meant the poor working class people of the countries all around the world. the pagans were just the regular people who were not connected to Caesar and your Roman Empire. They just were the regular farmers and the regular people who lived their regular lives and had their own belief system, and they were called pagans because they weren't like you, a big-shot Christian. And so when we say today pagans, it doesn't mean they were evil, bad. No, they're just like you. You would be called a pagan today because you are not in Washington, D.C., hobnobbing around with the president and making the big money and, you know, and being part of the big system that's going on. It's a big system, and it's a big club, and you ain't in it. So therefore, you're just an ordinary working-class person. Therefore, you are a pagan. That was a Latin word in Rome for an ordinary people, or pagan.